Mindfulness Fun. Today we are talking about the Enneagram 9 and the one thing that they need to heal before it's too late. And the thing that they need to heal is the throat chakra.
Isabel's a number, a type 9, and you would never think by watching these videos that she needed to heal her throat chakra. But let me just tell you this, her mom, she did not used to be this verbose, nor assertive, nor intuitive in her communication style. So it's pretty cool to see that this stuff actually works. But real quick,
but before we go on to tell you all the information on how to heal your type 9, how to heal your throat chakra, make sure that you like this video if you enjoyed it and if it was true and relatable. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn on post notifications so you don't miss a single video we're putting out.
So type 9s, before I get to them, by the way, check out the new swag.
Yes, did you see our new shirts, Make America Zen Again. I think we can all agree with that statement, so please click the link below on head over to makingmindfulnessfun.com into the shop to get your shirt now.
So in type 9s, the reason you need to heal your throat chakra or balance your throat chakra or open up your throat chakra, whichever way you want to look at it, is because you are the peacemaker and you just like to maintain peace. You don't want to rock the boat. And a lot of type 9s mistype as type 2s or vice versa. And similar type thing that with type 2s, we did say that you need to work on your throat chakra, but you also tend to, as a type 2, have a little bit of root chakra blockages also. Type 9s, not so much. You're not so much that you're fearful of the world or you're not trusting. You just are like, you're just so zen, right? That's why I made the shirts, type 9. She just, normally a type 9 really likes to just embrace peace and just kind of go with the flow and make life easy. And you don't necessarily want challenge. It's just, and so sometimes it's hard for you to speak up and be like, yes, I want to do it, or no, I don't. You're actually not even necessarily thinking if you want to do it or not. You're just like, oh, whatever, sure.
Yeah, and that's really, I'm going to get into that in a minute. But in case you don't know much about the type 9 and you think you might be a type 9 or have a type 9 in your life, the type 9 is called the peacemaker, and you are in the anger triad. And this can be really shocking for people, especially for myself. I thought it was shocking, but then it clicked, which I'll get into in a second. And type 9s, you're gonna naturally be calm people. But I really wanna touch on the triad, because while as type 8s and type 1s, you're gonna either repress or express your anger, type 9s, you fall asleep to your anger. And this was a big one for me to realize, was that when type 9s feel any emotion that would cause conflict, we just ignore it. We try to push it out of our lives, push it out of our vision, and just think, oh, everything's fine. Because our core desire is harmony. We just want to feel harmonious and peaceful with our environment for the sake of our own being. And so what ends up happening with these people, I see it all the time, and even with myself as I was younger, is that because we're falling asleep to that anger for so long, it's building up without us noticing. And all of a sudden, one day, we just explode. We explode with our anger and take it out in harsh ways, and it's not healthy. That's why the throat chakra is so important, because if we can just slowly instead just express that anger, express what's feeling wrong, express what we need, express our desires, then I noticed so much for me. This was so big. It was that, oh, there's not that heavy feeling there of anger weighing on me. There's not this seething like resentment that's making me feel like I can't express myself, that I'm not valued. I felt valued suddenly. I felt like I could state my opinions, and I felt so much healthier, and the people actually appreciated my opinion, turns out. So that's why the throat chakra is so important for type 9s to heal.
That was great. The things that type 9s can practice right now to start making that transition into that place of empowering throat chakra balance is a couple of things. So one, throat chakra is about expression, so the expression of our voice. But sometimes if the thought of the expression of your voice sounds too intimidating, amazing way to start, and I think Isabel would agree, would be to start expressing yourself creatively. Mm-hmm. Isabel began playing instruments. Playing instruments are an amazing way to express yourself. Start singing, start dancing, and writing. Writing can be another way, and that's another thing too. So type 9s need to start working on expressing their anger a little by little instead of just falling asleep to it. I think a great way for that practice could be writing letters, what you would say to someone, or actually start expressing that boundary, almost like a type 2, expressing that boundary to someone who causes you anger little by little, but contemplating it before it comes out. That way it doesn't all explode out at once.
Yes. And a type 9, a lot of times you might not even realize that it's even anger. It takes a lot of mindfulness before you get to the point that, oh, I'm a type 9, and that's actually the root emotion there is anger, because it might just be unawareness of a desire. So another one to do is just by journaling, desire. What is my favorite coffee? What is my favorite ice cream? What is my favorite thing to do? If money was an object, where would I go today? Who would I go with? All those things, because type nines, you're not necessarily aware of that you have a desire, and usually anger is a reflection of an unmet desire. So when you get blindsided by an emotion like anger, you're like, whoa, where did that come from? Because you didn't realize there was this desire to begin with. So trying to dig out, ooh, what do I want? What do I want? How do I want my eggs?
Journal and creatively express yourself. And also leave a comment below and express if you're a type nine and how this you deal with this struggle, because we love to hear your expression, type nine.
Challenge for you.
Challenge you right now. It's like I'm a type eight. Leave a comment below and make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And that was it.
I hope you like this series. We'll be back tomorrow with a new series.